My name is Karl Dyall, born in London, father from the West Indies. I've lived there a few years before I came to Sweden, as I think I came here when I was 11, so I feel quite Swedish. Three kids and a wife, and the owner, co-owner of CrossFit Solid. My father's a jazz musician, so we've been in showbiz. Has been a part of my life since I was born. I started theatre school in London when I was five. Started tapping with my sister. I had my own band back in the 80s. We were doing hip-hop music. I've been dancing all my life as well.
This is mostly so, since it's a big theatre, it's mostly so people can see my expressions. It's not that I'm trying to.
I think it was back in the late 90s, I got my first hernia, my slip disc. I got a second hit slip disc, then I fractured my hip. And it actually stopped me in my tracks. I had to give up what I was doing, my profession. I thought I was in the way for my family, I was in the way for people around me, I was unreliable, and I couldn't really do stuff. I couldn't lift my youngest child. I wasn't strong enough to be able to hold her in my arm. I was totally depressive. I had I had really dark dreams, like a lot of people that get into that dark way of thinking, you stumble over instances of, oh, I gotta quit it. What I was focusing on was just being without pain, trying to get the pain away and trying to function again. I had one of my best friends, he'd stumbled upon the CrossFit.com site and read about CrossFit and all the different exercises they were doing there.
Bear complexen, här vill jag att det inte slarvas någonting, även om det är fem varv, så är det fokus här. Ner på backen, precis i nacken. Bra form där, snyggt.
As long as it was bodyweight stuff and gymnastics stuff, I would actually try doing the wads. And before I knew it, I was pain-free and I had won most of my function back. And best thing of all, I was working again.
I know Carl from when we started the box. Not too long after we started CrossFit Nordic, they started CrossFit Solid. But pretty much from that point on, and then onwards, we got to know Carl. He worked out here, we worked out there, we saw each other at competitions. Pretty much since day one, we've been hanging out.
The first time I met Carl was at a global gym called Friskis Fettis, really close here. So I saw him just like working out, and he was like extremely fit, and he said CrossFit on his shirt. The next day I was standing beside him and doing a long workout with wall balls and just like enduring stuff. It was so fun, and that was the first meeting with Carl.
He's probably the most humble person that I know. He's always got time. What I really like about Carl is that you talk to Carl, you notice that he listens to everything you say. It's never like he drifts away and stuff like that. It's like he actually listens to what you say. And that to me is huge. It speaks volumes of who he is as a person. It's not just, if he talks to you, he listens to you. There's time and there's some kind of effort into, he puts effort into what he says afterwards as well. It's just, he's a very good guy and I look up to him a lot.
I know I'm getting a lot of my energy from what I'm doing in the box. The hard thing is probably the responsibilities of running the box and then switching focus, like, okay, left that, now it's a new thing, now I have to rehearse all these lines for Othello or something like that.
When it comes down to the gym, he got like always this great energy that like a super positive and so nice to everyone, and everyone lights up when they see Carl. He's just like one of the best guy you can have at your box, and to be your box owner, he's great with everyone.
Elaine is the one with the red short salmon-colored shirt, and William Walker just, excuse me, that was Carl.
He's smart. He's just really, really smart. He has a game plan. He's gonna stick to that game plan. He goes through the workouts before he goes in there, knows, what kind of pace should I be going at? How should I pace myself through this workout? how many reps should I do? I mean, he's a smart competitor. You very rarely see him just hit the wall in a workout. He'll do it afterwards.
He can go all out. He can go so hard, he, you know, like faints, pukes, and it's crazy.
He'll go to that dark place and stay there and then leave it once he's done with the workout. We saw that at the games this year.
All kind of neck and neck.
Karl Dyall.
Looks like Karl Dyall
did quite
well in the deadlift ladder, coming out to a slight lead.
For me, it was hilarious. I would have never expected winning the opening event. I knew I was strong, I knew I could lift some weight, but they're some big guys, I knew they're strong, I know what they can do. So I was just, like, the first event for me was mostly just not losing too many points.
Karl, successful at 495.
Interesting thing about Karl Dyall, he's got an entertainment background, studied dance.
Out of Stockholm, Sweden.
That's great. Long way from home, he's here to represent.
It's really inspiring to see him, because the first time I met him, I thought he was like 25, 26, and then I heard he was like about 40, and I was like, shit, I didn't think you can look that fit when you're like 40.
We want to be able to do the same things that they do when we become masters ourselves. But also in the box, you need some kind of opposite towards the testosterone-prone 23-year-old guy who just goes balls to the wall every time. And that's a smart athlete, and that's what you get in the Masters.
I had some dark moments in the games as well. But, I mean, it wouldn't have been fun if it wasn't challenging. So I wouldn't have wanted to change anything, you know, actually. Nothing. Dramatically, it was just perfect.